Okay, we've already covered many of WISE's features on the channel, but until now, we haven't had a separate, comprehensive, step-by-step video on how to create and set up your account. In reality, questions might arise at this stage, and we see them from time to time, so today we're excited to clarify everything for you. Let's go through each step of opening a WISE account together, figure out which type of account you need, business or personal, and find out what to do once you've created your profile. My name is Andrea, let's dive right in. The first thing I recommend doing is to click the link here in the description or in the pinned comment. Next, you can either tap open an account or scroll down and download the app, where you can also go through all the same registration steps. Now I'll demonstrate the steps using the app and the mobile web, but these are the same on the desktop. Regardless of the method you choose, we recommend having the app downloaded so that your money is literally at your fingertips and you can manage it as quickly as possible. Okay, when you tap open your account on the mobile version or get started in the app, you'll see the same screen. Since we're signing up, tap on register and proceed to enter your email address. There's also an option to sign up with Facebook, Google, or Apple ID. Important: make sure you have access to the email address you register with and that it belongs to you. Otherwise, you won't be able to confirm your email address or receive updates from us. Next, we choose the type of account, personal or business. Let's quickly figure out which one you need. If you plan to make personal payments, you won't receive money from freelance work or a business and simply want to manage it for your own purposes, then the personal account is the right choice for you. If you're a freelancer or a business owner and need a profile to receive payments related to your business, pay salaries, or manage your company's money, then you should choose a business account. If you're still unsure about which profile suits you best, feel free to ask in the comments of this video. We're here to help. An important point: WISE, like most other financial institutions, may not be able to provide full service in all regions. We continuously work to make our amazing products available to as many customers worldwide as possible, but there are restrictions. For example, it might not be possible to open a business account in certain regions. Additionally, while WISE works with most types of businesses, there are some exceptions that we can't onboard. The ones relevant at the moment of this recording are shown on your screen. Next, depending on your choice, we will ask you where you reside most of the time or where your business is registered or pays taxes. After that, you'll need to provide a phone number. Again, it's important that this is your number and that you have access to it, as you will receive a verification code there. Then you will create a password, and with that, your account creation is complete. If your code doesn't arrive, make sure that your device can receive text messages, that you're checking the correct number, and that you have a network signal. If you still don't receive the SMS, try turning cellular data off and then on again, restart your smartphone, use a local operator if you're roaming, or select the voice call option. Since we chose to create a personal account, let's take a look at what to expect when setting up a personal profile. Once you select your password, we'll ask about your goal with WISE today, whether it's to send money or start using balances in different currencies, order a card, receive transfers, and so on. Essentially, this choice only affects how we assist you in the next steps to make it easier for you to navigate WISE. Regardless of what you choose, you will be provided with the widest range of functionalities available in your region. Like all of our other customers, you will need to go through verification. We've discussed the verification process in detail in one of our videos, but to summarize, WISE's verification process is similar to other financial institutions that adhere to regulations and ensure your money and information are secure. We may ask for a photo of you and your ID document, as well as information on how you plan to use WISE. For business verification, we will ask you to provide details such as business registration, where you're located, the industry you're in, any online or social presence, your name, and some other basic verification questions. Rest assured, the verification process is as streamlined and as quick as possible. We aim to verify clients as fast as we can so you can start using all of the features on your WISE account. Once verification is complete, you'll have access to all the features available in your region. A question we often receive is, WISE, why do you talk about opening balances in different currencies in your videos, but I don't see that feature? If you don't see a particular feature in the app, it means that, unfortunately, it's not available in your region yet. As mentioned, WISE products are available in most countries around the world, but there are still regions where you might not be able to hold balances in different currencies, order a card, or open a business profile. We are working every day to ensure that users worldwide can enjoy the full range of WISE services in the future. So now that you've created your profile, you're ready to move on to this video, where you can explore all the features of Wise app in detail. Also, I recommend checking out this playlist. It contains videos on almost all of Wise's products, and we're always adding more videos here. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments. See you next time!